State Secretary of the Electrical Trades Union, Peter Simpson. Welcome up, Simmer.
Thanks, comrades. I hope you don't mind me calling you comrades, because comrades is what we are. Anyone that opposes these laws is a comrade of mine. Whether you ride a bike, whether you come over in a Honda 90 like I just did, or whether you walked over. At the end of the day, these laws, as everyone said, don't just cover bikies. Don't even mention bikies in the legislation. It's hard coming and speaking at this time of the proceedings where everyone else has said all the stuff that needs to be said. But what I do want to say to you is give you a bit of a history lesson from the trade union's point of view. And I'm only speaking from our point of view, from the Electrical Trades Union, not on behalf of any of the others. It's us that have been asked to speak, so we'll give you our spiel. About 6 months ago, we put a full page ad in the Courier Mail. Some of you might have saw it, a picture of Adolf Hitler. And we compared him to what this bastard's doing in this state. That was about the Transparency and Accountability Act. It was an act that's supposed to try and stifle trade unions' rights, trying to stop us from campaigning and spending money against this government. It was a pretty successful piece of legislation. A lot of unions now can't campaign unless they go out and ballot all of their members, which costs about $50,000 to $60,000 to run a ballot. It takes about 6 to 8 weeks to run the process. So you can't react overnight. If he changes the laws today, we can react tomorrow under the old regime. Under the new regime, we have to run these bullshit ballots. And that's costing our members money, it's costing our members time. The way it works in the trade union movement is, if your members don't like you, they fucking vote you out. That's what they do. They don't go through all the bullshit that this bastard's trying to put in place. At the end of the day, if you're a trade unionist and you're a member of a union, you don't like the way the leadership's going, you turf the bastards out at the next election. We're all up for election the same as these clowns are. So guess what we've got to do to these clowns the next election? So that was the Transparency and Accountability Act, and that was back in May, and I copped an absolute bucket load of phone calls middle of the night from gutless bastards on private numbers. What we were trying to point out at the time was, though, we're not trying to praise what Hitler did, quite the opposite. We were trying to show what was coming, and that was back, like I said, back in May. Since then, the VAD laws hadn't even been thought of. Well, sorry, I think they've been thought of, but they hadn't been put into act. I've got a theory that the VAD laws were sitting there without a title on them. He was waiting for someone to erupt. He was waiting for a trade union to run a picket line and have a blue. He was waiting for some group in the community to come out. And unfortunately for the bikies in Queensland, it was the blue that happened down at Broadbeach. And straight away overnight, you don't write a piece of legislation that thick overnight, trust me. And it was straight away dropped out. So it wasn't just about bikies. I reckon it was lined up for trade unions. We weren't there in the gun first. You guys were. And when I say you guys, I know some guys in motorcycle clubs. Some of our guys have got good relationships with guys in motorcycle clubs, Outlaw and the rest. My son rides a friggin' motorbike. Like I said, I rode our Honda 90 over today. I've got a motorbike license ever since I was a kid. People should be able to ride and associate with whoever the fuck they want. That's what the state's all about. So, people have been saying, why is the trade union movement out the streets? Why haven't we shut the place down? Well, we're under attack too, comrades. They've come on us. The new Abbott government's already passed legislation making it illegal to take industrial action outside of an EBA. There's $34,000 fines to each individual that takes illegal industrial action. They've put moves in place to ban picket lines. Picket lines have been the string in our bow for 100 years, or more than 100 years. The MUA dispute, remember it well. I remember the bikies that rode up to the MUA dispute bringing wads of cash to support the guys on the picket line. I was there with them. It's good stuff, and that hasn't been forgotten, I can assure you. So you've got the Transparency Accountability Act, you've now got the VLAD legislation. As the previous speaker from Civil Liberties talked about, it covers anyone that little from Nambour decides that he wants to cover. He's got the ultimate power in this now. He can overrule judges, he can overrule any bastard he wants. One of the earlier speakers spoke about the CEQEP dispute. I wasn't around in the CEQEP dispute, but I came into our office after the CEQEP dispute and saw the aftermath of it. They had a thing called the Continuity of Supply Act back then. Any three CEQEP workers that congregated in a group, or any three workers that congregated in a group, that was deemed to be a union meeting, and they could be arrested the same as you can be under this legislation. We thought that was a bad act of Parliament. This is way, way, way worse than that. There isn't one place in the Western world or any country that I can think of where this sort of legislation has been put out there. And it gets worse. I went out for dinner the other night with an old mate of mine. He's about 70, he's dying of cancer. And his young bloke, a real good young bloke, young grandson, came out to dinner to make sure he was looked after. And this kid looks after his grandfather like you wouldn't believe. He's got tattoos all up his neck. He's got covered in tattoos. Never owned a motorbike in his life. He don't care as much for bikes, but that's his gig. Tattoos are his gig. We're talking to him the other day. He went out shopping and he had to get a cab over because he doesn't drive. While he's waiting, he thought, I'll slip into the pub and use the free cab phone. and ring a cab to get, you know, take me groceries home. While he's doing that, he's walked out the front waiting for the cab. The coppers have grabbed him and searched him and photographed him and went through his fucking groceries. Is this the state that we want to live in? Seriously. So, comrades, what you're doing is brilliant. There's got to be more of this. The dead set has. The trade union movement stands, or the E2U stands beside you, shoulder to shoulder. Some people are a bit nervous about being associated with bikies. I'm proud to say the electrical trades union aren't. So stand tall, do more of this shit. Let's get out in the streets and show them. Now, in closing, I'll say to you, you've got one chance to show this government a very clear message, and that's in early February in Redcliffe. Anyone that lives in Redcliffe, put the Liberals last. Put them last on your ballot paper. Check who else that they're preferencing, if it's Family First or some other group. Put them last as well. Put them second friggin' last. Make sure we win the Redcliffe seat. Make sure it gets lost, sorry, by the LNP by 25%, and send this prig a message. Thank you very much, comrades. Well done.
Thank you, Simo.